Later viewers, the Colonel speaking to you live from the Grange for British Imperial YouTube Broadcasting, and thanks to the gracious permission, Your Imperial Highness, of a nobleman, we're able to play his master's voice, 02538, The Witness, by T. Wick, sung by George Robey, yes. His Highness's collection consisted of a number of fine music hall, classical, operatic records, and some very fine machines. Here we go.
You'd not guess in a day. I get my living witnessing the weddings slyly done at the registry office. The game's a paid one. No wedding bells go ding ding dong while boys all sing a saucy song. Bring along your bit of cuddling in case you make a muddle as a witness. Call on me. You know, it's extraordinary. Positively extraordinary. The way I got into this profession from this country, you see, the Curtis case. I was out of work and looking for a job. I don't mind confessing to you as we're all together that I was practically on the verge of starvation. Something had to be done, so I wandered forth. And during my peregrinations, I passed a big building. A man rushed out, came up to me and said, "Oh, sir, would you oblige me and be a witness?" I said, "A witness? What for?" He said, "A wedding." I said, "No, blooming dear. I'm going to be no witness to any wedding. Thank you." He said, "But I will pay you." Well, it doesn't even matter. Something had to be done. I thought to myself, now, here's a man's happiness standing between me and starvation. Love is blind and I'm no oculist. I was tempted and fell and got half a crown for doing it. Yes, I know. I know it's a wicked way of getting a living, but something had to be done, as I said before. My due retribution was on the track. When I got home that night, I never slept a wink, thinking over what I've done. I tossed and rolled about in bed. You see, I've been married myself, so I'm an experienced. Still, when daylight came, things didn't look black, so black I thought, why, she has a good idea of making a business of it. So I smartened myself up a bit, put on this suit and this hat, and went down to the registry office and stood about there and waited a bit. And believe me, during the first day, I've rolled 10 different lots of couples to get married. But during that very hot summer, you know, when there's a lot of people got a touch in the dual alley tap. You know, you'd laugh if you'd study watching them. These people, when they come up there with that far off look on their face, some of them roll up there in motor cars, some come up in cabs, some run up, some creep up. Well, the creepers are in the majority. Now, last them! Did you see last Thursday week with a regular nut came up there to get married? I know he was a nut because he kept saying my hat and top hole and shall go and priceless and words like that. I know he was a nut because he tossed the registrar double or quits with a two-headed ace mate, paid me with a bad half dollar, got in the cab and got out the other side just as he was leaving. He knew how to get something for nothing, that fella did. And you know, we get them all ages too. Now last Good Friday, there was an old gentleman rolled up there, of course. I don't know, I ought to call him a gentleman, because subsequent events rather disprove that statement. Well, you take my word, he was 97 years of age if he was a day. You know, one of those, thank goodness I've got me health and strength, but oh dear, oh no, no. He got a young thing with him, about 16, if you please. I said, "I'm very sorry, sir." I said, "I'm afraid we haven't got a font." He said, "You'll pardon me, sir. This is my fiancé." I said, "Get out." I said, "I'm going to be no party to any kidnapping." I heard the old villain had been up there 7 times the week before with a different bird each day. I recommended him round the corner where you'd get a game license. I said, "Anyhow, you're not hardly worth ashamed of yourself. A man of your age, nearly 100, coming here to get married to a young girl of 16. You don't do that sort of business here." And the excitement of it, would you believe me? Some of these couples are in such a hurry to get married, they forget to bring the wedding ring with them. So I always keep a lot of these handy, you know. These are rubber ones out of lemonade bottles. They go off like hot cakes at the bob of time and fit any finger. And no wedding bells go ding ding dong while boys all sing a saucy song. Bring along a bit of cuddling in case you make a muddle as a witness. Call on me.
Well, that was most interesting, wasn't it, viewers? A real piece of the old music hall there. Hopefully you enjoyed it. Thank you and goodbye.